So this week on the Inkedwell, we're going to be doing something we haven't done in quite a while. We're going to be doing an unboxing of a Sailor Bro gear. I say quite a while, but the last one we did was the Graphite Lighthouse. This particular one, though, is the Pro Gear Angel's Delight as part of the Cocktail series from Sailor. This one comes with a nice thank you card from Nagasawa, because before I got it from its previous owner, they got it from Nagasawa. And on the inside, we've got the lovely navy blue box with Sailor stamped in gold, with air quotes, and a gold band going around the entirety of the navy blue box. I really like this touch. It's one of the things I do like about Sailor. On the inside of the box, we do have the Angel's Delight itself, and underneath the pen rest, we've got the plastic sleeve that the pen came in. We also have the sale and warranty card from Nagasawa. I don't read a lick of Japanese, and the pen is actually on its way to New York right now, so unfortunately, I won't be able to Google translate that to see if I'm actually right. Aside from that, we do have two Sailor cartridges, and the Sailor Care and Use Guide for the Pro Gear Angel's Delight. It also has some filling instructions for the included converter. Aside from that though, not much else in this box, but there was quite a bit in there to begin with, so it's a pretty good overall package. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the body. One thing I at least do like about this pen is the colorway, and how they do the floating finial. We've got that nice effect here of the anchor floating above the rest of the pen, floating above this lovely cream color cap, and they even continue that effect at the end finial as well. And I love the deep purple plum body. Now, uncapping the pen, it's the standard Pro Gear length here, so it's not too short of a pen in that it will still at least make contact with the inner crease between the thumb and the forefinger, and the section is a good width as far as sections are concerned. If you need the pen a little bit longer, it easily posts. Normally, I wouldn't recommend something like that, but hey, everyone's different. The key feature here, though, is this lovely 21-karat Sailor hard medium nib. This is one of the better medium nibs that I have actually ever tried, and we'll get into a few things here in a minute why that's actually kind of a shame. But one last thing to touch on before we go ahead and do the writing sample, I do love this converter. Compared to any of the converters from Pilot, honestly, even the standard international converters that you get from custom pens, I prefer this converter over all the others. And I think they did a really good job on the body, making it just translucent enough to where you can see it, but opaque enough to where it's not a distraction. Enough body talk though, let's go ahead and get writing. And for this writing sample, we are going to be in the Endless Works Tomoe River Paper Notebook. The ink that we're going to be using is my tried and true Diatramentis Petrol. With this particular pen, I wanted to give it a good shake with an ink that I know like the back of my hand, and that one tends to be it. I know exactly what to expect from it, I know what kind of flow it's going to give me 9 times out of 10, so if I'm having any issues, it's really going to come down to an issue with the pen, not the ink itself. Which, if we're going to be honest with ourselves here, I know I'm not going to get any issues with the feed or the nib from this pen. The nib came perfectly aligned, there were no issues as far as flow is concerned, and the ink is being very truthful here. I'm getting a nice mid to deep color, which is something I expect from Petrol, out of a medium nib, and that is on display here. Breaking away from the writing really quick, one thing I did want to bring up is the overall size comparison. I was hoping that this would fit a lot like my M600 from Pelican, but as you can see, the pen, even though it is the same width, is going to be a little bit shorter, and the section is missing that little bit of concave that honestly I feel would help it go a long way to being a much more comfortable writing experience for me, and that's really where my love-hate relationship with this pen begins. I mean, writing with it, the nib provides one of the best experiences I've ever had. I've got a good line variation, the nib is flowing very well, especially with this ink, but it feels like it's chunky in the wrong places, it feels a little bit back heavy, and I noticed, like when I was doing the nib width test here, that it felt like it was going to push out the back of my hand because there's no concave to this grip at all, and that's just leading to a weird writing experience for me. So where does that really leave me on the Sailor Pro Gear Angel's Delight? Well, for those that have been watching the entire video and made it past the 3-minute average that a lot of people tend to watch, you'll notice that I said earlier this pen is on its way to New York. I ended up not keeping it, and a lot of it has to do with that section. It doesn't matter how good the colorway is, it doesn't matter how beautiful the nib is, if the section isn't there, and the weight and proportions just aren't where they need to be for your hand, it doesn't matter how much you want to like a pen, it's going to sit, and it's going to go unused. At least now, I know it's going to somebody who's going to use this pen, who's going to enjoy this pen, and I feel nothing wrong with that at all. But knowing my mileage with the pen shouldn't dissuade you from getting a pen like this. If this is your colorway, especially with that cream going into the plum purple, going into the slightly lighter purple, then find it and get it. The one thing about these cocktail pens, Sailor does a really good job putting together intriguing colorways that really do represent the drinks that they're created after. I just wish they would do it for the Riallos instead of the Pro Gears. That aside though, that's gonna do it for this video. Thank you for watching, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, follow the channel on Twitter and Instagram, social links are down below, and consider supporting the stuff I do over on Patreon.com. That being said, I'll see you guys next week.